I've found 10 plus super cool and useful ways to use ChatGPT's image generation model. These are the kinds of tricks you'll want to use every single day. Let's dive in and see how you can bring them into your own work. ChatGPT 4.0 is amazing at generating creative ads. If you're someone with lots of creative ideas, this example is perfect for you. Check out this minimalist doodle art style ad. Let me break down the base prompt so you can use it easily. First, we have the style of the design, a minimalist and creative advertisement set on a clean white background. In the second line, just replace the real object with your own product, or anything that can go along with your product. This will be a real picture. For example, you can use a scented candle, a piece of clothing, or anything you sell. Then comes the doodle concept. This is where you show your creativity. Describe the idea you want in the design. For example, I chose Nutella and peanut butter. For the real object, I wrote, a real slice of toast with Nutella spread on it. For the doodle concept, I wrote, the doodle shows a painter holding a brush, painting on the toast like it's a canvas. Then for the ad copy, I used, spread the art, and told ChatGPT to place it at the top middle. Of course, you can change this text to fit your product or style. Lastly, I told it to place the brand logo at the bottom and gave a few extra instructions for how I wanted the final design. As you can see, these designs are super creative, perfect for standout social media posts. When you use this prompt from the description, you just need to change the bold highlighted parts. The style of the prompt is already set, but you can tweak it to explore different versions with colors, fonts, and styles. Alternatively, if you're out of creative ideas, you can paste this prompt directly into ChatGPT and ask it to generate some ideas for your brand. Make sure to provide all the details about your brand, your product, and your logo. You'll get tons of creative ideas to try. One thing I'd like you to know, if you continue generating images one after another in the same chat, ChatGPT will carry over details from your previous images. As you can see here, that can sometimes lead to unintended design overlaps. So just start a new chat, and it will work smoothly without any leftover details. Here's another cool thing you can do with ChatGPT. It's called Voxel Art. Basically, it's a 3D shape made of pixel blocks, kind of like the Minecraft style. As you can see, I've created voxel-style icons of emojis, which was really fun. You can add any emoji you want and then use this prompt to generate similar results. It doesn't stop at emojis. You can also use images of characters or even your brand's logo. For example, I used this image of a girl that I generated in Midjourney, paired it with my voxel art prompt, and got this really cool result. Here's another example with logos. I know a lot of you comment that you don't always get the same results I show in these videos. That's because even if you use the exact same prompt, AI will always give you some variation in the result. We can't control that. My advice? Just generate again and add more details. Or you can take a screenshot of the style you like and then ask ChatGPT to give me an image in the same style. That's how you'll get a more precise result. I've also added this image in the doc, so use it to generate voxel art if the prompt alone doesn't give you the result you want. Alright, here's the next fun use case. You can actually generate X-ray images using ChatGPT. Yep, you heard that right. Check it out. Here's an X-ray of my cat. And here's another one showing a metal plate installed on my wrist. I found this style really cool. All you have to do is give ChatGPT the image of your subject and use a simple prompt. You'll get these crazy realistic X-rays of your subject. This one's definitely worth trying out. Now, similarly, you can create these sealed pack frozen creature images, which is pretty cool to try out in your projects if you want to make things stand out. But here's an even more useful idea. I've created these miniature packs with specific items inside, labeled with a bold title and price, and they look super cool. You can do the same with your own products to create attractive social media posts and boost engagement. All you need to do is upload your product images and use the provided prompt. It's super simple and easy to create. You can also use this prompt with anatomical or scientific items, like organs if you're working on a science project. It's a pretty cool idea to try. Next up, this one's super awesome. It's called the Iridescent Glass Style. You'll find a JSON prompt for it in the doc. All you have to do is paste this prompt into the prompt bar and upload the image you want to retexture. That's it. ChatGPT will give you an iridescent glass version of your uploaded image. This works with almost everything. For example, I uploaded a screenshot of the iPhone webpage, and the result was super amazing. All these examples came out really good and so perfect. Definitely give this a shot with your logo or your products. It's a must try. All right, next one. This is another modern minimalistic style, perfect for product ads. This one gives a kind of soft, dreamy vibe with its frosted glass texture and pastel color tones. I've tried this with products from popular brands, but feel free to use this style with your own materials. If you want to retexture any image, just tweak the prompt. Add the colors you want. Remove the slogan and other unnecessary parts. That way, you'll get a more accurate and refined retextured result for your uploaded image. You can also retexture a map in a bunch of different ways. If you need maps from different historical eras or with specific elements, just ask ChatGPT and provide your map image, and you'll get these kinds of results. There might be some errors with the text, so you'll want to fix that in Photoshop. And if you want to create double exposure images, ChatGPT's got you covered. I found these images in Sora, and I really like the way ChatGPT creates these double exposure images. As you can see, the details and the sharpness are amazing. It really understands the prompt very well. Now, I also have a prompt to recreate plush toy style emojis or any of your images. This is a JSON prompt. All you need to do is change the emoji. If you want to recreate an image in this style, just remove the emoji part from the prompt, add attached image, and upload your picture. It will give you results like these. I used an image of a car and got this soft, plush, toy-style version. Here's another example with the Apple webpage. It did a great job, even recognizing each iPhone model without confusion. I also uploaded a Nivea product post and got this fun result. Definitely try this style to grab people's attention. If the prompt doesn't work well, just start a new chat and add a bit more detail to the prompt. It'll work better that way. I also created these monster letters with facial expressions. This prompt is super simple. Just change the letter you want, pick an emotion you want on its face, and mention a color if you'd like. That's it! You can create these cute monster-style letters which are highly detailed and perfect for children's books or animated videos. And don't stop at monsters, you can try this style with any idea that comes to mind. And that's all for this video. All the prompts are in the description, so be sure to check them out. If you're new here, make sure to like and subscribe. You'll find some awesome content on our channel.